Hello students, welcome to today's session. So in this session we are going to see about Raspberry Pi. So Raspberry Pi is a series of single board computers made by the Raspberry Pi Foundation. So it aims to educate people in computing and create easier access to computing education. So it was founded by a United Kingdom charity. So Raspberry Pi is launched in 2012 and there have been several iterations and variations. So let us see in detail. So here the Raspberry Pi, it is a low cost mini computer with the physical size of a credit card. So Raspberry Pi runs various flavors of Linux. So it is operating system is Linux and can perform almost all the tasks that a normal desktop computer can do. So Raspberry Pi also allows interfacing sensors and actuators through the general purpose input and output pins. So since Raspberry Pi runs on the Linux operating system, it supports Python out of the box software. So it is a low cost mini computer. Its size is like a credit card. So it is a single board computer. By connecting peripherals like keyboard, mouse, display to the Raspberry Pi, it will act as a mini personal computer. Raspberry Pi is popularly used for real-time image and video processing, IoT based applications and robotic applications. So Raspberry Pi is a little bit slower than a desktop or laptop, but it is still a computer which can provide all the expected features or abilities at a low power consumption. So this is the greatest advantage of Raspberry Pi. So the features are the computer in your palm. So it is like a credit card sized mini computer. So it is a single board computer. If you can attach the several interfaces, you can use it as a computer. So it is a low cost. So the latest version is cost around 5000 to 6000. So and it is easy to access. So it is based on Linux platform. It is easy to access. So Raspbian OS is officially an operating system which is available for free to use. So this OS is efficiently used with Raspberry Pi. Raspbian have a graphical user interface which includes tools for browsing, Python programming, office and gaming. So here are all the specifications. So starting from Raspberry Pi 0, Raspberry Pi 2 model and Raspberry Pi 3 model and the latest version Raspberry Pi 4 model. So it has a random access memory with starting from 512 MB. So up to in the latest specification, it has 8 GB SDRAM. In Pi 3 model, it is having 1 GB and Pi 2 having 1 GB SDRAM. So here the CPU, central processing unit. So starting it's from ARM 11 at 1 GHz. So quad ARM processor with quad cortex at A53 at 900 megahertz operating frequency. So Raspberry Pi 3 is having a A53 with 1.2 gigahertz, and here the latest version is using A72, which is up to 1.5 gigahertz of operating frequency. Graphics processing unit, here the Raspberry Pi 0 is having 250 megahertz video core 4, and then Raspberry Pi 2 model having a 256 megahertz video core 4, and then 400 megahertz of video core 4. So here the 500 megahertz and video core 6. So here the graphics processing unit of Raspberry Pi model B of version 4. So here the Ethernet is having there is no Ethernet for Raspberry Pi 0, and then Raspberry Pi 2 is having a 10 to 100 megabits per second. So here the Raspberry Pi 3 model having a connection speed of 10 to 100 megabits per second. So here it can support up to 1000 megabits per second. So the wireless connection, it is both Raspberry Pi 2 and 0 is not having wireless connection, but Raspberry Pi 3 model and Raspberry Pi 4 model is having 802.11 in Raspberry Pi 3 and Bluetooth connection 4.0. So here the 802.11 AC, which is used in Raspberry Pi model 4 with Bluetooth 5.0. So here it is having high standard, high definition multiple cable. So here the video output, that is HDMI, high definition multimedia interface, which is of a composite type, and then having all four models. So GPIO pins, general input output pins, is having a 40 in every specification of Raspberry Pi model. So here the basic architecture. So the RAM, which is having a the latest version, is having a 8 GB up to 8 GB of SD RAM. So it is a central processing units and general graphics processing unit. So with the USB hub, which is having a Ethernet connection, and for USB ports. So here the latest version having two USB ports 2.0 and two USB 3.0 ports, and then having 40 general purpose input and output pins. So here the Raspberry Pi board. So it has an ARM based Broadcom processor, which is SoC, system on chip, along with on chip graphics processing unit, that is GPU. So the CPU speed of Raspberry Pi varies from 700 to 1.5 GHz, and also it has an onboard SD RAM that ranges from 256 MB to up to 8 GB of onboard RAM. So Raspberry Pi, which provides on-chip SPI, that is serial peripheral interface, and intercommunication, that is I2C, and UART modules, universal asynchronous receiver and transmitter. So here it is having GPIO headers, that is general purpose input output pins, which is having 40 in numbers. So, and it is for a video connection, RCA. So in old model, which is supporting RCA video type. So, and it is having an audio jack with status indication LEDs, with USB 2.0. So latest version supports USB 3.0. So, and then this is for Ethernet. So it has up to latest version having a 1000 megabits per second connection. So, and then which is a CSI camera serial interface, that is connecting camera. So, and then HDMI port, high definition multimedia interface, and then micro USB power. So this is what are the power slot, inbuilt power, and it is having a SD standard definition card slot. Okay, so SD card slot, that is secure digital card slot, and then DSI connector display. So this is for connecting to the display, which is for you can use monitor. So let us see the components and peripherals in detail. So processor, the Raspberry Pi is based on the ARM processor. So it is advanced RISC machine, so it supports RISC computing architecture. So the latest version of Raspberry Pi model B version, that is revision 1.4, which comes with the 1.5 GHz 64-bit quad core ARM Cortex A72 processor, and inbuilt of up to 8 GB SD RAM. So here are the USB ports, which comes with two USB 2.0 ports and two USB 3.0 ports. The USB ports on Raspberry Pi, which can provide current up to 100 milliamps. So the for connecting devices that draw current more than 100 milliamps, an external USB powered hub is required. So in order to connect the device which draw more current, so we have to connect to the external USB power hub. So next to Ethernet ports, it comes with the standard RJ45 Ethernet ports. So we can connect an Ethernet cable or USB Wi-Fi adapter to provide internet connectivity. So HDMI port, high definition multimedia interface on Raspberry Pi, which provides both video and audio output. So you can connect the Raspberry Pi to your monitor using HDMI cable. So for monitors that have DVI ports, that is a digital visualize interface port, but no HDMI port, you can also use an HDMI to DVI converter, which is adapter cable. So here the composite video output, that is Raspberry Pi comes with a composite video output with an RCA jack. So that is a Radio Corporation of America connector, which supports PAL, that is phase alternating line, and then NTSC output, that is National Television System Committee. So video output So the RCA jacks which can be used to connect old televisions that has an RCA input only. So here the audio output. So Raspberry Pi has a 3.5 mm audio output jack. So this audio jack is used for providing audio output to old televisions along with the RCA jack for video. So quality audio quality from this jack is inferior to the HDMI output. So if you are connecting the old model, so the you will get only certain amount of efficiency. So if you use HDMI port, that is the latest technology, so you can get a very good audio. So GPIO pins. So the Raspberry Pi comes with a number of 40 number of general purpose input output pins. Okay, so there are four types of pins on Raspberry Pi, which is having true GPIO pins, and then I2C interface pins, SPI interface pins, and serial receiver and transmitter interface pins. So display serial interface. So here the DSI interface which can be used to connect an LCD panel to the Raspberry Pi. So camera serial interface, that is a CSI which can be used to connect a camera module to Raspberry Pi. So the status LEDs, the Raspberry Pi has 5 status LEDs which list in the tables. So ACT, which is meant for SD card access, and then PWR, it is the input power, that is 3.3 volt power, and then FDX, which is for full duplex LAN connection, and then LNK, which is link and network activity. So 100, which indicates 100 MB megabits, that is LAN connection. So the latest is having 1000 megabits LAN connection. So it is having a inbuilt SD card slot. So Raspberry Pi does not have a inbuilt operating system and storage. So you can plug in an SD card, that is secure digital card, loaded with a Linux image to the SD card slot. So you will require at least an 8 GB SD card for setting up of NOOBS, that is new out of the box software. So the power input to the Raspberry Pi controller has, Raspberry Pi has a micro USB connector. So it is having micro USB connector for power input. So these are all about components and peripherals. So Raspberry Pi, this is the Raspberry Pi model 3, model B, which is having a Raspberry Pi 3, model B GPIO headers. So GPIO, that is general purpose input and output pins, which can be used as an input or output and allows Raspberry Pi to connect with the general purpose IO devices. So these are all the 40 pins which are used in GPIO headers. So here the Raspberry Pi 3 model B, which took out of 26 GPIO pins on board. So it is the general purpose input output pin, that is dedicated general output true pins, that is 26. So the Raspberry Pi, which can control many external output input output devices using these general purpose input and output pins. So these pins are a physical interface between the Raspberry Pi and the outside world. So we can program these pins according to our needs to interact with external devices. So for example, if we want to read the state of physical switch, so we can configure any of the available GPIO pins as input, so and read the switch status to make the decisions. So we can also configure any GPIO pin as an output to control the LED on and off. So for example, I am using GPIO 5 as input and GPIO 6 as an output. So you can configure any general purpose input and output pins for connecting with the external world. So Raspberry Pi can connect to the internet using the onboard Wi-Fi or Wi-Fi USB adapter. So it is having a USB onboard Wi-Fi USB with adapter which is connecting to the Wi-Fi net connective internet connectivity. So it is having also onboard Wi-Fi 2. So Raspberry Pi, which is having these pins. Okay, so pin numbering, which is based on the which we want to use as an output or input. So which pin, which GPIO pin is going to be used as an input or output has to be declared. So it is having a two ways of defining pin number. So one such way is called GPIO numbering and physical numbering. So in GPIO numbering, which pin number refers to the number on Broadcom SoC, so that is Broadcom system on chip. So it should always consider the pin which is mapping for using GPIO pin. So while in physical numbering, pin number refers to the pin of 40 pin P1 header on Raspberry Pi board. So the above physical numbering is simple, as we can count the pin number on P1 header and assign it is as a GPIO. So we should consider the pin configuration diagram to know which are the GPIO pins and which are VCC and which are ground. So we should consider the pin configuration diagram which is about to know. So we should consider the pin configuration diagram to know which are GPIO pins and which are VCC and ground. So here the VCC is having first pin, second pin, fourth pin, and then 17th pin. So these are all meant for VCC input power. So and then for ground, 9th pin, 25th pin, and then 39th pin, 30 pin, and 34, 20, 14, and 6th. So these are all for ground connection. So here it is for a serial data and serial clock, which is for I2C, and then it is used for a serial peripheral interface, that is SPI, that is master out, slave in, master in, slave out, and clock. So and then in ST, that is I2C EEPROM, then IDSC for serial communication for I2C EEPROM. So here it is having a GPIO 14 and 15 is meant for UART, that is serial communication receiver and transmitter pin. So the Raspberry Pi general purpose input and output pin, which is having access both digital output and digital input. So they have the output which turns a GPIO pin high or low, and input which detects a GPIO pin high or low. So the Linux OS which is on Raspberry Pi having a Raspbian, Arc, Fedora. So the Raspbian Pi Linux is a Debian VC port optimized for Raspberry Pi. Then Arc is an Linux, okay, so it is based on Linux port for AMD devices, and Fedora Linux is a Fedora Linux optimized for Raspberry Pi. So and then RaspBMC, it is an XBMC media center distribution for Raspberry Pi. And then OpenElect, it is a fast and user friendly XBMC media center distribution. And RISC OS, so it is a very fast and compact operating system. So this is the screenshot out of a Raspbian Linux desktop. So after installing your with the help of a memory card, you will get the Raspbian Linux desktop as like a Windows desktop. So it is a Linux based OS. So it is a configuration tool for Raspberry Pi. So it is having a 9 number of configurations. So this is a screenshot of file explorer on a Raspberry Pi. So it is having inbuilt with my office documents and readers, portable document readers. So some basic applications. So this is the browser, inbuilt browser for Raspberry Pi. So this is the console, that is command prompt window for Raspberry Pi, as like in Windows OS. So these are the frequently used commands, that is cd which change directory, this is an example. So and then cat which shows the file contents, that is a particular file name dot text. So ls which lists the files and folders with example, and then which locates, that is a locate meant for searching a file, so that a file name dot text. So and then lsusb which lists the usb devices. So pwd, that is a print name of the present working directory. So mkdir which creates a new directory, and then mv which moves or renames the files with the source file name and destination file name. So rm which removes the specified files with the file name dot text. So reboot, it's option with an example sudo reboot. So it reboots the device, and shutdown in the device, sudo shutdown -h now. So grep which is printing the lines matching the particular pattern with an example. So df which is a report file system which displays disk space usage, that is df -th. If configure, it displays the network configuration details for the interface. So netstat, so it prints the network connections, routing tables, and interface statistics. with netstat -lmtp. So tar, this is to store or extract files from the tape archive, and tar -xzf fwo tar dot dgz. So wget, which downloads files from the web directly to the computer. So this is an example. So it is a basic setup for Raspberry Pi. So if you are having a Raspberry Pi with this additional, if you are having a Raspberry Pi kit with additional these peripherals and components, so you can use it as a mini computer. So you require HDMI cable, monitor, keyboard, mouse, and 5 volt power adapter for Raspberry Pi, and LAN cable with minimum 2 GB. So if it requires, if you can, if you have having 8 GB, it's well and good. So for SD card, so these are all the basic setup which is required for Raspberry Pi. So popular applications, so it is used in a media streamer, so that is a digital video and audio processing, and then home automation, controlling various home appliances and controlling robots, which is bots, and a virtual private network. So and it is used for lightweight web server for IoT, and it is used as a tablet computer. So far we have seen about what is Raspberry Pi with its features, specifications, and basic architecture, the Raspberry Pi board, and components and peripherals with Raspberry Pi 3 model BGPIO headers, and then a Linux OS on Raspberry Pi, and with the screenshots, and Raspberry Pi frequently used commands, and basic setup, and popular applications.